Yeah, this piece of junk works.
I'm coming for you, you son of a bitch. You'll regret it when I find your sorry ass.
And what happened next would jeopardize my plan.
HQ, HQ, this is Liev. I've reached the extraction point. Standing by for evac. Over.
We read you, Liev. An Alpha team has been dispatched to your location. Hold position and get rid of any hostiles.
There's no hostiles in the area. Over and out.
Not so fast, Agent. You really think you can walk away from this?
Sandman. Son of a bitch. How is this possible?
Your guess is as good as mine. But aren't you the least bit curious of how your little stunt affected me? Oh, come on, Leaf. You still got one more round to show me something before you throw in the towel.
Nah, I'm throwing it in. See, I've got a flight to catch. And to be honest, I don't give a fuck about boxing. You throw your hands pretty fast, Major. I'll give you that. But tell me this. Can you throw your hands faster than a bullet? No, no, no. How the mighty have fallen. Without the safety of your helo, you're knee-deep in shit and your neck high in deeper shit. On a crash course to soiling those pretty hands of yours. Tell me this, does it ever cross your mind what you did to me at Groom Lake? No? Well, this time, you're stuck on my battlefield, bitch. And you'll be the one bleeding out, not me. Oh, I've been looking forward to this for so fucking long. Cause when it's all said and done, you'll be remembered as a traitor.
Who is this squawk too much? You know, life is really just like boxing. You psych your opponent into thinking you'll do one thing, then you do another. You got only yourself to blame for this, Leaf. After all, you're the one that made me this way. Oh, come on, Leaf. Stop shaking. You look ridiculous. Knockout. You know, I could have let you die back in 94. Yeah, letting you die would have saved us both a headache.
The state of the board had gotten worse, and Sam Walker was officially the next mouth to stitch shut. Especially now that I had lost control of my pawn and the ability to recover our precious samples.
system. This is not a test. Repeat, this is not a test. Stay tuned for further instructions. This is not a test.
said that?
Stay where you are. Don't move.
What the?
Look for the intercom. On your left. My name's Atherton. Dr. Atherton. I'm the chief surgeon here at Sacred Heart. My men and I have shut ourselves in the ICU. Quite possibly the last safe refuge in this hospital. Maybe the whole town.
What? How can that be? What the fuck is going on here? Listen, Doc. I'm looking for someone. A real nasty son of a bitch who got here shortly before I did.
Oh la la. You must be alluding to my latest patient.
Latest patient?
That's right. A real nasty son of a bitch indeed. He was the one who crudely dissected those security guards you've undoubtedly stumbled across. But alas, I managed to sedate him and now he's tucked away, as snug as a bug in a rug, under my complete control. Nobody will meddle in this hospital's affairs. Nobody but me.
Doc, open this goddamn door right now! That bastard's got an outstanding account with me, and I came to collect—
No, I'm afraid not. You simply don't have the authority to make that decision. As you can see from what's left of my staff, I too have an account to settle with this man.
Now you listen to me. I ain't gonna tell you again. Open the goddamn door!
However, settling accounts seems to be your niche. So maybe we can reach some kind of understanding.
What are you getting at?
How should I explain it? Yes. As a result of this precarious and unpredictable situation, some matters of the utmost importance remain pending. As you can glean from the carnage out there, I can no longer rely on security due to your friend's sudden appearance. So I need you to handle it instead.
Man, you are one insane motherfucker.
Insane or not, I have something you want. What you must do, sir, is go to the west wing of the hospital. Room 10, to be exact.
What should I do once I get there?
Don't be so rash, Mr.
Walker.
Walker? Oh, how appropriate to the situation at hand. Getting there alive will be a big accomplishment in itself, Mr. Walker. Now you'd better skedaddle. I am not a particularly patient man, and my offer may be prone to expire. You can contact me using the intercom when you... better yet, if you make it there. By the way, that technological marvel that beautifully decorates your delicate wrist, the one you clearly stole, will be very useful. Very useful indeed. Feel free to buzz me on channel 27. I'll give you more details then. Godspeed.
All right. I'll do it. Fucking fruitcake.
something like this would happen sooner or later. We've been playing God, but now we cannot escape the hubris of our astounding progress. The company, the government, decades of malevolent work. And my God, I helped them. And now, it's time to pay for our sins. Christ, what have we unleashed?
Sam here. Can you hear me, Doc? I'm in room 10.
Mr. Walker, what a pleasure to hear from you. Glad to know that you're still a fine specimen of good health. I can't imagine what you went through was easy. But the next step should be much easier.
What am I supposed to do exactly? I don't see anything.
Not to worry, Mr. Walker. You're in the right place. Although you can't see it, there's a special door in that room. Now approach the wall directly across from you with your DID.
Now what the fuck else has to happen? Hidden doors? Implants with damn chips?
Mr. Walker, I want you to listen very carefully. There are many forces at play which, unlike myself, you just aren't privy to. All you must do is do exactly as you're told, no matter how unsettling nor utterly unpleasant it may seem. Now hurry up and bring me that chip. Over and out.
what the hell is going on in this place. Secret control rooms? Continuous monitoring of the citizens of Keen Sight? How is it possible?